'Cause it's a new season. It's a new day. Yes, fresh anointing. I can feel it. It's flowing my way. Oh, oh, oh. It's a season of power and prosperity. It's a new season, and it's coming to me. Or if you believe that, lift your hands and say,
it's a new season.
It's a new day.
It's a new day.
Fresh anointing.
Fresh anointing.
It's flowing my way.
It's flowing my way.
It's a season of power.
It's a season of power.
And prosperity.
And prosperity.
Thank you. that this is a pre-anniversary. Amen. So we just came to kick something off. How about that? Amen. I just came to give a kick in the house. Amen. Amen. They tell me this is the 9th anniversary. So I just came to give a kick for the baby that's about to come. Hallelujah. And am I talking to anybody here? Hallelujah. I'm not looking at what's already here.
Yeah.
I came to get excited about what's about to come here. Y'all don't hear me. Hallelujah. If you understand what I'm talking about. That means something about to be birthed in this ministry. Hallelujah. You may not even see it yet. You don't know if it's a boy or girl. You don't know if it's twins or triplets. But something is about to be born. Oh, yeah, somebody say, and on purpose. On purpose. On purpose. She was big. Y'all hear what I say? She was big, child. Hallelujah. But when I saw her there, I said, wait a minute. Where is it?
Hey, God.
Because I know if she had it,
no.
I ought to be able to see it. So I was looking for the evidence of what she was carrying all this time. So I'm looking around and saying, where is it? Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Hallelujah. And by this time next year, you should be able to say, where is it? There it is. And talk to that. There it is. Brand new building. Brand new. Brand new people. Brand new. Brand new system. Am I talking to anybody? Brand new. Somebody said, God, thank you for the brand new. It was an open door opportunity. I came to preach to somebody in here. Somebody, open that door.
Yeah.
Now do me a favor, open up another door. And open up another door. Because that's what you see is not going to be just one door.
You better say it. You better say it.
That's why it's sweatless. You're not going to need a key. You're not going to have to open it. When you get to it, it's already going to be open. Can I talk to somebody in here? Somebody been waiting for an opportunity. I came to drop a bomb on you. The opportunity is here right now. You have already entered the season. You're not waiting for it to come. It came when you were sleeping. And I just called, came to tell you to wake up. Your season is here. Get yourself at the door. Hindering you from going through what you're about to go through. Can I talk to somebody in here? Is it all right? Let me flow with you. Yes. I'm trying to get to the scripture, but I feel the flow of the Holy Ghost. The scripture says in Genesis that God came to Abraham when Ishmael, his illegitimate son of the slave woman, was just about to enter 13. He came purposely at that time, because when a child reaches 13, all of the possessions of their father, all the inheritance was given unto the child at 13. So God came and stopped him and said, you can't give it to that one, because that's not the promised child. Hear what I'm saying? And we're trying to put energy and all of our good stuff in something that's not the promise. Oh, y'all don't hear what I'm saying? And just because it may be working temporarily for you, you got to go back in your spirit and say, God, I know this is good, but this is not what you promised. And there's still a promise on each and every one of your lives. And God told me to come and tell you, don't give on the promise. He said to Abraham, don't wait a minute. This ain't the one. But he said, Lord, this one's been with me a long time. And this has been so good to me. And he's treated me like a father. He says, I don't care how good he's been to you. There's a promise coming. Oh, y'all hear what I'm saying? You've been faithful in this little thing. And as big as this ministry, this is a little ministry compared to what you're about to. Am I talking to anybody? I don't care what job you're on now. That's just the beginning job. That's not the real job. Y'all don't hear me. I don't care where you're living at. That ain't the real house. What you're about to get is the real thing. See, look at this. In the month of September, just in case some of you don't know, the Hebrews, the Jewish people, celebrated Yom Kippur.
Yes.
Yeah, can, can I say that? You know what I'm talking about. They celebrated the beginning.
Right. Come on.
Last month.
Yeah.
Oh, Holy Ghost. So the scripture says that they kick off the new year. Yeah. In other words, God people, we present a new year. Yeah. In other words, we carry the new year. Yeah. So we don't wait for January to come.
Come on.
We carry the world into the new year. In other words, we're the first partakers of the blessings of God before anybody else get it. You ought to have it before they get it. Oh, y'all don't hear me. Before anybody else appreciates the blessings of God, the children of God get the blessings first. Of September, it was an open door.
Yes.
And the door had an eye. There was an eye with the door. Meaning you need perception to know what door to go through. Because sometimes there's so many possibilities. You don't want to enter the wrong door at the wrong time. It's the timing of God. So God said, I need you to have open eyes and ears. In other words, don't let somebody tell you to go through that door. Make sure you see the door.
That's it.
Can I talk in here? Is it all right?
Yes.
This is a new service, so let me get down. Scripture says that the Lord told Abraham, in order for you to have this next move, I need you to circumcise. I need you to cut off what's covering the floor. Cut off foreskin. Am I talking to anybody? I'm not going to talk about it. I need you to cut something that's blocking a full flow. You got a little flow. Oh, Lord have mercy. You first. We want to cut everybody. We want to help everybody. But you better get yourself first. And you know why it's hard to cut yourself? Because it hurts so bad. It's easier for somebody else to do it for you. The young lady said, don't have people coming up here laying hands on you know all the time. Stop doing it yourself. Cut yourself. He said, Lord, every time I get the knife next to me, I'm hurt before it gets to me, but this time it's going to get to me. Because I got a promise. Oh, y'all hear what I'm saying? Everybody blame it from somebody else for not getting what belongs to you. But I came to tell you, God said, you're your own problem. Scripture says that the Lord told Abram, cut yourself. Now cut yourself, servants. And the beauty of this thing is that they're all hurting at the same time. Listen to what I'm saying. All the men, all the servants, all the slaves, they were all circumcised. Men, y'all know what I'm talking about. They was in pain. I'm hurting, baby. But the good thing is they were all hurting at the same time. So I feel you, and you feel me. I can't look down on you because I had to cut me too. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying? So if we're all going through at the same time, we can all begin to sympathize with each other and say, I got you and you got me. Or am I talking anything? This is an open door season. Lord said, look here. To get through this door, you got to cut. Scripture said that after he cut, he went into a tent. He was in a place called Mary. Mary means strength. So he went into a place to get strength.
Yes.
Oh, Holy Ghost. He had to step out of pain and get into strength. And while he was in the tent, the scripture said that three men like angels came to him. And as they began to come to him, he was in the tent door. He was in the process of being healed. But even while being healed, he saw his miracle coming. He got up in pain because my opportunity has finally come. Oh, you hear what I'm saying? I may still be bending from last season. I still may be hurting from last season. But baby, I see an opportunity. Y'all gonna hear me. I still may be getting over some things from the last season. I may have even had to go into bankruptcy the last season. But this season, I ain't got all that I want to have. But I see this one coming. Somebody said, I see this one. God ain't waiting for you to get yourself together.
Come on now.
Move while you're hurting.
Listen.
Move, baby. Opportunity's here. Nobody wanna go with you? That's okay. I'm going through this door. Sarah's still in the tent. But I'm going through this door. Oh, y'all don't hear what I'm saying? I see my help. Scripture said when the angels got to him, he began to make preparation. They said, this time, next year, Sarah gonna have your baby.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, God.
Wait a minute. I'm old. And she ain't having nothing. He said, I waited until it looked like it wasn't going to happen. Because I wanted to make sure what you think is your power. Is it your power? I want to let you know that what you think is working for you, that ain't what I'm going to use this time. I'm going to use something that's specially made. Oh, y'all hear what I'm saying? I'm going to use the power of the Holy Ghost to flow through that spot that was blocked all this time. in your life that you thought was bad, I'm going to use it for your good. Can I say this to you? I just came to throw a bomb in here. On purpose is on purpose. And this place cannot hold on purpose. And if the house is blessed, the people in the house are blessed. If the house is moving, the people in the house are moving. Oh, y'all hear what I'm saying? Because God will never bless the house and not but bless the people in the house. And come on, you need to get excited by that. It sounds strange, but this year, we're going to laugh. We're going to laugh. Because so much is going to come to us.
Yeah.
We're not going to know what to do but laugh.
Yeah.
Am I talking right? And I don't know about you, but I done cried enough that I'm ready to laugh. And I'm not just ready to laugh. I'm ready to laugh right in those people's faces and thoughts that it's never going to happen. I'm going to go right up in their faces and hold on. I'm going to walk in those people's faces who had rumors out about me and said she'll never be no great advancement and say, ha! Because of God.
Yes.
Can I say this to you? There's a door. Listen to, look at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Wow.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Wow.
God's complete number. God's perfect number. I dare you to get up. Stop crying and start laughing. Scripture says, when they told Abraham, he laughed.
Uh-huh.
When Sarah heard, she laughed.
That's the book.
When the baby came, they called him Isaac. Laugh. Start crying. Wipe your tears.
Yes.
This is a year of open door.
Oh,
be sweatless. You're not going to have to beg nobody to let you in this door. You're not going to have to kiss up to nobody to go through this door. You're not going to have to sell your integrity. Can I say this? You're not going to put down who you really are and sell yourself. Because if that door won't let you in, that one is open. But you need eyes. Because the enemy heard God say open doors. And he opened the door too.
Come on.
Scripture says, in, I believe it's in the book of Romans, it says that Paul said that there was an open door, great open door. But when I got to the door, adversaries were around the door. And that's how you know it is the door. Because you need to see an enemy trying to block you. And that's how you know that's your door. But God is going to strengthen you so when you get to the door, to kick him out of the way and say, move out of my way. This is my season and this is my door. Somebody say my door. It's got my name on it. It's got my name. Opportunity, season of the open door, opportunity. Cut what still remains. Cut what still holding you back. Circumcise your attitude. That you still have not cut is gonna block your Mike, you messed up on me. But I want somebody to do something very powerful. You young lady. I see you said it's coming soon, it's already here. It ain't coming, it's here. God said, do me a favor. Walk through the door. Your name is in the door.
Get the door!